एक तो सबसे पहले एवरीबॉडी आई एम वेरी वेरी सॉरी फॉर द लास्ट टू एपिसोड्स. आई हैव बीन टोल्ड बाय अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल दैट माय माइक वॉल्यूम वाजंट करेक्ट एंड वाज कॉजिंग देम अ लॉट ऑफ इनकन्वीनियंस.
वरुण
सो आई एम
ठाकुर,
सॉरी
वी हैव टोल्ड इट
दैट
टू यू इन द मिडल ऑफ द पॉडकास्ट.
दैट दैट नो यू एसोल्स. बाय द वे दीज गाइज आर एसोल्स बिकॉज बिफोर आई स्टार्ट रिकॉर्डिंग आई चेक विद देम बाबा एडिट सो बाबा कैन हियर इट एंड नन ऑफ देम सेड एनीथिंग वाज रॉन्ग. यू
मैं
जस्ट
तेरे को दो
ब्लेम
बार बोला है,
इट ऑन देम.
आई हैव डन वन फुल एक्सटेंसिव
क्या कर
ब्रेकडाउन
रहा
विथ
है?
यू.
देर इज
एक तो पहले बोला था आवाज
वीडियो
खराब है, वो मेरा कौवे जैसी आवाज है, वो मैं कुछ कर नहीं सकता. ठीक है, वो पैदाइशी
एविडेंस,
आवाज में पैदा हुआ था, मैं खासा था पहले बार. ठीक है,
देर इज वीडियो
मैं रोया
एविडेंस
नहीं था.
ऑफ अस सेइंग डोंट कम सो क्लोज टू द माइक,
या
डोंट गो
अभी
सो.
भी तेरा माइक दिख, तेरे गले के एकदम एकदम ऐसा
तुमने
दो
तुमने क्या
सेंटीमीटर अरे
ऐसे ऐसे रहो क्या?
माइक को साइड में रखना. देख बाबा का माइक किधर है, तेरा माइक किधर है.
अभी मैंने
हाँ
सेटिंग कॉपी किया है बाबा का,
नहीं,
जो
तू
जो
आगे ले ले, तेरा सेटिंग तेरे लिए
अभी
सही है. बस
देख शुक्ति अभी आगे ले पीछे ले, तुम
प्लीज
क्या माइक के साथ ये करते रहो क्या?
राइट इन द कमेंट्स वेर यू वुड
जिफ
लाइक वरुण ठाकुर माइक टू बी प्लेस्ड.
बनाओ रेडिट पेज के लिए, जिफ बनाओ.
बस
अभी ठीक है, ये आवाज ठीक है, ये
या
वॉल्यूम ठीक है.
ए बाय द वे गाइस, लाइटिंग का मेरा ठीक है.
अभी
हाँ
एक मिनट आ रहा हूँ.
Why can't you do this before we start recording?
बाबा ओके जस्ट टेल मी, इज दिस बेटर
No.
और इज दिस बेटर?
बाबा
नॉट इवन
बा
दिस. व्हाई इज
इसका
देयर सो मच रिफ्लेक्शन ऑन योर फेस?
बियर्ड इज टेकिंग
बिकॉज
ओवर द लाइट.
लाइट लाइट इज
तो
राइट हियर
कैन यू ग्रे योर बियर्ड? लाइक कैन यू स्टार्ट स्ट्रेसिंग एंड देन हैव इट टर्न ग्रे?
ब्रो. एट 31 इट्स ऑलरेडी फार ग्रेयर देन इट शुड बी.
या हिज बियर्ड
या
इज ग्रेयर देन माय बियर्ड एंड आई हैव गॉट 11 इयर्स ऑन हिम.
माय माय डैड
हाँ, तेरे को
डैड
कुछ
यूज
चेक
टू
करना है? तेरे को कुछ चेक करना है कि नहीं, कि सिर्फ हमारा ही में
मेरा
प्रॉब्लम?
बैकग्राउंड ठीक है क्या गाइस?
हाँ बस
थोड़ा कुछ लगा ना यार तेरे
थोड़ा
बैकग्राउंड
खर्चा कर,
पे.
पीछे लगा एक पोस्टर,
सीरियसली
तेरा स्पेशल का पोस्टर लगा, एक प्लांट लगा. बार बार बिल्ली लेके आता है तू यार. नहीं तू गाइस, इफ यू ऑल वांट बाबा टू हैव व्हाट, ओके प्लीज सजेस्ट इन द कमेंट्स व्हाट
या
बाबा कैन ऐड इन हिज बैकग्राउंड दैट विल अप द प्रोडक्शन क्वालिटी ऑफ दिस पॉडकास्ट.
Let's up the production quality of the podcast in 3, 2, 1.
Hello and welcome to another episode of the Internet Set. So, a show where we take randomistic universal facts and trivia and opposite stories and we talk about it. And today, what I want to talk about is not I, we. Guys.
No, you can talk. We'll leave.
Okay, bye. Okay, bye. So, you know, I wanted to ask you guys, ki, you think money can buy you happiness or what?
You know, I feel like we've started a podcast about this with the same question at some point or the
I
other.
think our answers are also the same because my answer is still that money can't buy you happiness, but it can buy you enough things around you to make you not unhappy.
Yeah.
Okay, what if you have a lot of money and then a big gangster is after your life? Fir?
Yeah, but then you can have security.
As
Okay,
someone
but one
very
of the security
succinctly put
guys
it,
who you are paying very less amount to gets offered double the amount by gangster.
अरे बट
Then,
देन यू पे देम इनफ ना, यू गेट द राइट सिक्योरिटी,
but what if what you're paying them is not enough and it's a greedy bastard?
देन यू आर फक्ड एनीवे ना.
No, because I was reading.
आई डोंट थिंक द गैंगस्टर केयर्स, देन दिस गाय ओनली विल डू हिज जॉब, सो इट्स फाइन.
No, because I came across this what do you call it? Instagram पे जा रहा था ना, तो one of these facts वाला pages that I follow, they put this one post out, okay, and it's about the craziest shit that Nicolas Cage has bought. ठीक
निकलेस
है,
केज द
Nicolas Cage.
एक्टर.
By the way, उसका अभी जो मूवी आया ना, वेर द अनफैथमेबल वेट ऑफ एक्सेप्शनल टैलेंट और समथिंग, वेर ही इज प्लेइंग निकोलस केज. एनीवे, सो निकोलस केज का वन सीन इज दैट ऑल थ्रू द 90s एंड लाइक अ लार्ज पार्ट ऑफ 2000s ही वाज मिंटिंग, राइट? एवरी थर्ड मूवी वाज अ निकोलस केज मूवी. ही वाज
बिकॉज बिकॉज ही नेवर सेज नो, यू नो दिस राइट? ही नेवर सेज नो. यू कैन
हैज द
पिच हिम
वन
एनी
पावर सिंबल,
मूवी.
लाइक आई विल नेवर से
आर
नो.
यू सेइंग ही इज द अक्षय कुमार ऑफ हॉलीवुड?
यस यस आई टोटली एग्री दैट आई एम निकोलस केज. सॉरी, निकोलस केज इज मी.
You think Akshay Kumar plays Nicolas Cage in Nicolas Cage's biopic and Nicolas Cage plays Akshay Kumar in Akshay Kumar's biopic?
Yes.
Bro, by the way, there is one very funny, extremely funny sketch on College Humor about this very fact that Nicolas Cage never says no. The sketch is from the perspective of his manager, okay, who keeps getting these weird movies, okay, butts in space. And he's like, Nicolas, yes. But here the movie. No. You mean no? Yes.
Nicolas Cage. Yeah. So, because he can't say no and he's doing all of these movies, he's making bajillions, okay? So, he is insane, wherein he has spent money on getting, like, exotic animals. He spent $250,000 on some fucking octopus.
Just a random octopus?
And two king cobras.
Wow. Okay.
Albino king cobras, no?
Huh?
Albino king cobras. They were a special, like, they were...
Uska dada lage.
They were
100%. So, albino king cobra, if that exists, then that is the base level, bro. He and Leonardo DiCaprio once got into a bidding war on a dinosaur skull.
Wow.
Him and Leo are going, are 10 lakh, 50 lakh, game. Wo. Finally, he bought it only to realize that it was stolen. So, the person he bought it from had actually stolen it from somebody else.
By the way, Leo stopped bidding for the dinosaur skull after someone told him it's over 25 years old.
But
the thing about
can you imagine Leo's face when he hears 65 million years? Oh.
I just want to say that Nicolas Cage, you're saying that the fact that this dinosaur skull that he got was stolen, these king cobras that he used to have, would try to hypnotize him and kill him. He has said this in an interview.
I wouldn't be surprised if Nicolas Cage said that one of the king cobras turned into an Ichhadari Nag and now he is Arman Kohli from Janet. Movie possible.
So,
But guess what he spent 1 million on?
What?
On a not limited edition, but the only collection of number one action comics where Superman made his debut. Action comics from.
Oh, I thought he spent it on the first Superman comic.
No. So he bought a series of action comics car thing for $1 million. Okay.
Wow.
Which was stolen
by the same guy who had stolen the dinosaur skull.
But he managed to retrieve it and then he sold it for a profit, 2.1 million. Usne finally becha.
Listen, out of all the movies Nick Cage has done, why not a movie on this?
Yeah. Seriously. No, but like, dude, he's got two islands in the Bahamas. He's got like a Gulfstream jet. You name it. Matlab, when I was reading that, I was like, bro, iske paas kitna paisa hoga wo time pe? Ki usne jaake seedha sab khareed liya. And that brings us to the topic of this episode, which is the lifestyle of the rich and famous.
Cold open ke baad introduction.
Cold open ke baad ek thoda lukewarm open into topic of the day. But because then I saw this, मैं चले गया एक रैबिट होल में और ढूंढा कि ये सब सेलिब्रिटीज जो इतने सारे पैसे कमाते हैं वो किस पे खर्चा करते हैं एग्जैक्टली ओके एंड शिट गेट्स अब्सर्डर सो ऑन द लिस्ट वी हैव लेडी गागा ओके लेडी गागा स्पेंट $2 million ऑन गेस व्हाट चलो गेम खेला जाए ऑन गेस व्हाट
It's a suit that's made out of asbestos that was taken
It wasn't $2 million. This was $50,000. $2 million is somebody else on something. I'll come to that. $50,000.
$50,000.
Sorry, Varun, is it cheating if I've already read it?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, then let's not play this guessing game and only one person doesn't know.
Quiz for Kautuk. Anyway, yeah. So she spent $50,000 on a ghost detection machine.
Outstanding. I would also pay that much money for that.
So she is constantly paranoid because she gets so much unwanted attention all the time. She's just supremely scared of ghosts. She claims that she can see ghosts. Okay. And she's had she's very superstitious. She's had paranormal experiences or whatever. She's even gone to the extent of calling Ghostbusters.
Not Bill Murray and friends.
In general. Okay. So then eventually after chatting with the paranormal experts, they decided that she should buy an electromagnetic field reader. Mm. for which she spent $50,000.
Hey, can I tell you something? I genuinely think that, you know, I feel like the richer the person is, the easier it is to pitch and sell them things.
MVP.
Right? And you can make a whole industry out of crap that only rich people use because of their own.
If you are a not a rich person, you are a poorer person, right? And you have felt ghost this, that, tu seedha bhagwan ka murti rakh dega. Theek hai, bole bhai bacha, mere ko ek le le, electromagnetic field reader nahi chahiye. Theek hai?
So I was
the pullback of, oh, money is an issue. I can pretty much sell anything to you.
Yeah,
little
yeah.
Masala, little coating on top, little putting fear in you, and you'll be like, yeah, bro, get me that.
Yeah.
So I was reading this. I was reading this article about, like, you know, rich people who have who are slightly worried, who are also slightly paranoid, who are also slightly worried about what's happening, and it comes from one concept called sudden wealth syndrome. That's also a
phenomena, psychological phenomena.
Yeah, it's a psychological.
That's phenomenon. So true.
So
and
recently, yeah, Thakur talking about it.
Yeah, so
hashtag relatable.
Suddenly, मेरको अगर बहुत पैसे आ गए तो मेरको तो हो जाएगा sudden wealth syndrome.
So the thing is, it comes from all that. But what was really funny when I was reading this is that very recently they have added that the cause could also be from people who have bought cryptocurrencies.
Yeah.
So it is about, like, lottery tickets and things like that, where you suddenly just end up acquiring a lot of wealth. So I was reading there's a Guardian report and a Atlantic report that I was reading about the fears and the fear psychosis that happens once you sort of reach a certain thing. And what was interesting, Thakur, you will like it, is because that Guardian piece was linking, was constantly associating itself with the show Succession. The therapist,
I like it. Don't ask the story also. I'm sold.
No. So I finished the first season. Now the thing about this is that they constantly live in such an isolated world of the people who have either known them before their success or have proven themselves over literally walking through fire for them. Otherwise, they're constantly worried about, you know, if they meet
the intentions of the people around them.
The people who are around them, what do they want from me? Is someone trying to scam me? So the funny thing is, for them, they seem a little more skeptical when it actually comes to buying shitty things. So this metal detector, etc. If you are catching the right psychosis, right, and you are able to convince the person, then you are golden, because then they are a golden goose.
Yeah.
Right. Then they will just keep spending on whatever you sort of feel. However, there is it's very difficult to pass that wall of trust to be able to get into them, because they're constantly paranoid, constantly fearful. What's also very
funny. But Bawa, tell us something. As an advertiser, what are the tricks you would use to get past the high walls of defense of ultra rich people?
Are, but ultra rich people don't need to be
Bawa,
they are the ones making them. They are the ones making them.
I think all of this fear, right? Which is why the richer you get, I think the more rings start coming on your hand.
Yeah.
More stuff starts coming. You know, फिर तेरे धागे बढ़ जाते हैं, तेरे नाम में बेवजह के extra चार वावल घुस जाते
हैं. Yeah.
Absolutely true.
Consonant घुस जाते हैं, and then तू सब कर रहा है. You will, like, oh, you know, I heard that if you go to this place of worship, which wherever it might be, and udhar ye hota hai, udhar zyada karne lag jata hai, because they're constantly, like, very distrustful of people around them, because the minute you come into money, you're just like, everybody's after that. They've forgotten the old Mukesh, you know. Actually, he was always born into money. Chal, they've forgotten the old Dhirubhai, jo aise apne saath rehta tha, time pass karta, abhi itna bada ho gaya. I think it's a very normal thing to feel.
So there was this really famous quote. There was this really famous quote that I'm reminded of from what you were saying. I don't know who said it, but it was one of these like modern day philosophers. And the quote was that the extremely rich and the extremely poor have to believe in God because the middle class can only believe in themselves.
So it
feels like Chomsky, but it's definitely not.
There's one other very good quote from John Maynard Keynes, I think, who and it's very relevant currently. The quote is that if you owe $100 to the bank, that's your problem. If you owe $100 million, it's the bank's problem.
Yeah.
All his next pictures should be just him on his thug life glasses, mouth mein cigar hai, gale mein chain aur likha hai.
It's 100 million banks
problem. It's the bank's problem.
Sorkin has paraphrased this into something saying, na, if you owe the bank $100, if you owe the bank whatever, some $20,000, the bank's in trouble.
You know something, if any other writer does it, it's called plagiarism. If Sorkin does it, it's called paraphrasing.
No. Sorkin only has said good writers borrow, great writers steal.
Yeah.
Sorkin has not said that.
I know. That's the irony.
I'm saying yes, as because it seems believable.
No, that's the irony. That's the irony, is what I'm saying.
But I'll keep interjecting in the middle with other stupid expenditures that celebrities have done.
Okay, wait.
Also, you will love this one.
Huh.
I'll do this, then you take yours.
Huh. Okay.
Huh. So, this is done by one of Kautuk's most favorite artists ever. Kautuk, will you tell people who that person is?
Is it Bono?
Sawal. Correct.
Did he fly his hat in a plane?
And Kautuk is wishing, I don't mind being Bono's hat. So for those of you who don't know, basically Bono gaya vacation pe. ठीक है और उधर क्या बोला ऑफ फक मैंने अपना हैट फेवरेट हैट तो पैक किया ही नहीं अगर अपने होते उधर तो क्या करता तू एक तो मैं हैट पहनता नहीं दूसरे बात मैं बोनो हूँ ठीक है मैं वहां का जो भी सबसे महंगा हैट बनाता है मैं खरीदूंगा या किसी से बनवाऊंगा कि खास ये काम कर मनीष मल्होत्रा तू ये हैट बना सर मैं हैट नहीं बनाता ये ले पैसे यस सर बनाता और बना दिया ठीक है बट बोनो ने वो नहीं किया बोनो बोला मेरी हैट आएगी मेरे पास And because it's Bono's hat, it travels only first class. Because it needs to have travel insurance also.
this hat flew, this, and by the way, this hat flew in the cockpit.
Oh, must it have. Flew. I don't know. I wasn't there.
No, it flew in the sea. It flew in the cockpit. And then there was a chauffeur that picked up the hat to go and deliver it to him.
Imagine a chauffeur standing outside with a board and उधर लिखा है Bono's hat.
और Bono का hat भी आ रहा है बाहर और इसे देख रहा है सबको. हाँ, Bono's hat.
अरे सर आप Bono's hat है. इसे तेरे को इधर कोई और hat दिख रहा है क्या?
उधर उसके बाजू में Mono's hat का एक खड़ा है.
Mono's cap होगा. Mono के पास hat नहीं है ना. Mono के पास cap होगी red color की side से जा रही है. लेकिन Bono की hat $1,700. $1,700.
But Thakur, it's understandable because Bono can't live Bono or with or without his hat.
हाँ कौतुक Bono environment नहीं करता है बहुत
देख
अभी कैसे justify करोगे बताओ कौतुक बताओ
Bono when he also flies normally buys two first class seats because he doesn't
it's for him and his hat
no he doesn't want to have anybody sit next to
him. What this is true
And first class mein also there's actually a wall in the middle, so I don't know who is.
Hey, but listen, to be fair, and I'm not just saying it because it's Bono. To be fair, any celebrity, okay, who's that well known, would not want to sit with rando person because rando person would spend the entire long flight
same logic,
just
same
going.
अपने
वो गाना जब लिखा था क्या सोच के लिखा
अरे कौतुक लेकिन तू नहीं है ना फर्स्ट क्लास में
अरे पर जो भी है एक बार तो पूछेगा ना तेरे को कि क्या आप
नो इट विल यू नो व्हाट इट विल बी इट यू नो व्हाट इट विल बी एंड आई एम टेलिंग यू दिस बिकॉज़ ऑफ एक्सपीरियंस नो आई विल टेल यू व्हाट इट विल बी एट बेस्ट इट विल बी दिस राइट लाइक द गाय कम्स एंड इट विल बी लाइक बैग रख दिया और बैठ गया उसके बाद बंद
ओके कैन आई टेल यू समथिंग
10 करोड़ बनाने का उसको ये फ्लाइट से वो
एक सेकेंड देर इज वन मोर थिंग ओके
एक बार
सो it's really happened okay I was going for a college show to Ranchi okay as I was boarding the flight there was a girl who was in the line and she saw me and she said are you Kautuk I said yes she says aap bhi Ranchi aa rahe and she was very disappointed for some reason so
It's a subliminal fuck you to
Ranchi. It was so disappointing for her.
वो किधर left लेके दिल्ली जा रही है कुछ तो bro वो खुद Ranchi जा.
I think she was from Ranchi. She was like why?
Okay, one more. Next from Bono's plane ticket for his hat. We go to the power couple, Beyonce and Jay-Z. ठीक है तो बियॉन्स तो बहुत खरीदती है उसने अपने पति के लिए 50 मिलियन का जेट ले लिया ठीक है बिकॉज एज इफ यू नो द थिंग इज व्हाट एक्चुअली बिफोर आई गो इनटू द स्टोरी व्हाट आई वांटेड टू फिगर इज यू नो व्हेन वी थिंक ऑफ गिफ्ट्स फॉर आवर पार्टनर्स इन दिस यू नो समटाइम्स वी आर लाइक यू नो आई रियली नो शी लाइक्स दिस बैग सो आई एम गोना यू नो सेव अप एंड मेक श्योर दैट आई गेट हर दिस बैग व्हेन यू आर Jay-Z एंड यू आर Beyonce Your casual gift
yeah.
is a private jet worth 50 million.
Yeah. That and chances are that would still seem cheap.
Yeah. You think he looked at the jet like, maybe I actually don't like it?
Oh, Beyonce. But it's not like Beyonce shopped for it. Beyonce didn't shop for it and said, is pe deal mil raha hai ki nahi, 10% discount hai ki nahi. But they're great tax write-offs. So they're also being bought like that, and then of course they get into the whole like to burst your bubble. What also happens to them is that then they also become like timeshare jets, right? They'll become
investments.
People are flying them and all of that. So
that's the reason like most luxury goods and all exist because of all the tax benefits you get for them.
No, luxury products are taxed on most things unless you buy them as a company or something like that. लेकिन तू 350 million Rolex नहीं खरीद सकता ना.
Beyonce और Jay-Z का accountant नहीं घुमा सकता है क्या?
घुमा सकता है. घुमाने को तो कोई भी घुमा सकता है. But मैं बोल रहा हूँ ऐसा 50 million का jet लेके तू उसको नहीं घुमा सकता ना क्योंकि तू land करेगा जब DC में तो उधर आएगा तेरा टैक्स अटर्नी बोल लेगा कि भाई सुन ये सब तो ठीक है.
उसने राइट ऑफ नहीं लिया लेकिन उसने फिर भी 50 मिलियन का जेट दिया ठीक है. Anyway, then she bought herself $500,000 ka leggings made by Balenciaga.
Ooh.
Which are gold plated.
Oh, that makes sense.
She performed in once at the BET Awards in some 2007 or something. Mm-hmm. Okay, full gold leggings. Dusre side pe Jay-Z, who was almost like brand ambassador for Cristal, the champagne brand. Okay, he cut ties with Cristal. And on one night, he was at a club where he had this champagne called Armand de Brignac, Brignac. Okay, Armand de Brignac. Usne wo raat ko, it's known as basically in the connoisseurs of champagne and all, this specific brand is known as the Ace of Spades. Okay, so at a party in Miami, this guy has bought 75 bottles for $250,000. And then left a $50,000 tip for the bartenders.
अरे proportion.
इस पेटी वो रखे गया bartender को tip. This is this club called Live in Miami. फिर वो रात को पीने के बाद उसको इतना अच्छा लगा that the next year after this happened he bought the company.
This is also the thing na of the super rich ki. If you like something, you have the ability to possess it.
Yeah.
Not just purchase it, possess it.
बार बार फोन करके मंगा रहा नहीं हुई. अभी मैं अगर कंपनी खरीद लिया तो मैं ऐसा नल खोलूंगा तो अरमान दे ब्रिनियाक निकल
गया. Can I tell you something? On a like as a, I don't know how to put it. Like it's I can understand the impulse, but I'll put it down. Like I'll bring this down to a very small scale. Okay. So what I mean is, so when I was in school, I used to love only one pen and that pen was Hello Pointec. Okay. I loved writing it. I love writing with it. It's the correct weight and the correct whatever. Yeah. So for me, it was hello pointing. It was the right sort of pen. And maybe there's also a little bit of superstition. Ki, oh, I write better with it. Whatever. So when you're in school, you have to ask your parents to buy you things. And they don't buy you things like crazy people, right? They'll be like, get three pens, finish them, get refill, then finish those. Then if
it's Reynolds completely... ka leke hai, Reynolds ka white.
So they used to get me like, you know, just a normal amount of cello pointex. I'm not saying that I was deprived. It was the correct amount of cello pointex. But when I got a little bit of money and I got my own house, I was like, I'm never going to run out of cello pointex again. So I went to a website that sends you, I got 50 cello pointex and 100 refills. And there is no point in my house that you will be within.
I used to love this. Ye gel pen hai na?
Yeah, dude.
Yes, bro. I used to love this.
The classic.
Ripper was for maths exam. This was for all language papers.
It's the classic. And the thing is that I was just like, I'm never going to be an arm's length away from a cello pointex.
Total 50 pen aur 100 refill pe
kuch bahut chindiya.
I
don't know, man. It was, but it wasn't. It wasn't 50 million for sure.
So
I've earned my cello pointex. I've made it.
So I you spoke about gold-plated, like gold-laced, gold whatever leggings. This story sort of ends with, I mean, it doesn't end well, but there was this gentleman in Pune. His name was Datta Fuge, right?
Is the Vada Pavala?
Huh?
Ujo Vada Pavala Datta?
No. He used to be a money lender and he made a gold shirt for himself.
हाँ ये देखा है ये मीम पे बहुत घूमता है और ऐसा ऐसा खड़ा है वो उसके हाथ पे भी अंगूठी
है yeah.
and the thing and the gold shirt itself
खत्री साहब हर धनतेरस पे उसका फोटो डाल दो
1.2 crores or something like that and he obviously was unfortunately he was murdered or whatever but the fact yeah so the fact is not for the gold shirt or anything but like he was murdered but the fact that he had that shirt itself used to weigh 10 pounds
wow 5 kgs
about 5 kg ka shirt pehenke ghoom rahe okay sorry now I just wanted
quite inconspicuous of him like I wouldn't tell he just came into money okay. If I saw him on the street I'm like ah ye to kya normal kapda hai to pehenke wo manish market se liya ho
iske paas 1000 cello pointek to honge
Okay, so now I'm just going to take you through four or five things that have happened in India. Okay,
India.
Yeah, no. That are only lifestyle of rich and famous.
India ke 10,000 saal ke history mein se 4-5 jo cheeze hui hai.
Okay, so apart from obviously you know people having serving the finest veal to their dog and all of this is all amateur stuff. Compared to what I'm about to tell you. Okay. So, I'm quoting from a Vice article. Okay. So, only a few months back, this person is talking in the first person. And she said, only a few months back, the president of a multinational automobile conglomerate who holds immense sway over the Indian politicians was staying at a hotel where this person worked in the housekeeping department. Late into the night, he would step into the lobby with 24 security guards surrounding him and start crawling and growling on the floor like an animal. And he would ask his guards to do the same thing. It sort of gave him some sort of power trip. Wait, it doesn't end here. Wait. He then proceeded to have dinner, not from his own plate, but from the plates of his two escorts who he'd sit on his either side. He'd call them Sundari and Param Sundari. And he sort of enacted this animal ritual every night in the lobby for over a month in front of visitors who just silently witnessed this.
Wait, this
was cell phones and nobody's taken a video?
This is definitely during the time of cell phones.
He is the president of
automobile.
Multinational conglomerate of an automobile company.
Yes.
कौन है भाई चल रिड्यूस करते हैं
और नो आई ट्राइड टू रिड्यूस इट्स नॉट पॉसिबल
आई मीन आई जस्ट कांट पिक्चर रतन टाटा डूइंग दिस
सो आई नो ही इज नॉट सीईओ ना एनीमोर सो
माय गॉड दिस इज क्रेजी
आई हैव ट्राइड टू रिड्यूस इट इट्स वेरी वेल कुशनड सो एनीवे
मेबी दिस पर्सन जस्ट रोट द रॉन्ग इन्फो एंड इट्स नॉट एन ऑटो कंपनी इट इज
मेबी
फार्मास्यूटिकल्स यू नेवर नो
नाउ This is about the
But one second, why are we moving on from this?
Yeah.
Hold on. Apology. Hold on.
No. See, because the article says he then proceeded to have dinner, not from his own plate, but from otherwise they would have said not from his own bowl.
I feel like out of these two escorts, one escort is getting the worst end of the deal. Because A, she's not getting to eat food. Then she's being called Sundari while the other is called Param Sundari.
So the thing is, he's done this for a month. And what is this? Like, you just get onto the floor and start. Dude, it's incredible. Okay.
What is this? It's like, it's a power trip thing?
That's what she said.
That's
what she thinks. Power trip, is what it
is. वो तो ऐसे ही बन जाएंगे यार अगर तू पैसा फेंकेगा उन लोग पे तो करेगा बट पावर ट्रिप आई वुड बी लाइक सिक्योरिटी को बोले चल तू कुत्ता बन तू तू मुर्गा बन तू ये बन आवाज निकाल
Can I tell you one theory I have? And the theory is this, that I feel like when you're that rich / that successful, there are fewer and fewer people to tell you one simple word, and that word is no.
Correct.
Right? Like, yeah, and if you know, I feel like at that point, when you're that rich, that successful, you get an idea. Mereko aaj lag raha hai ki main थोड़ा कुत्ता बन के देखता हूँ राइट आई कॉल इट द कान्या सिंड्रोम वेर ही इज जस्ट सो सक्सेसफुल फॉर दैट लॉन्ग दैट एनी डम आइडिया इज लाइक दैट सीम्स फाइनल रन विद इट आई एम अ जीनियस हु नोज एंड नो वन टेल्स यू नो बिकॉज पीपल आर जस्ट लाइक मे बी ही नोज बेटर मे बी दिस इज द सीक्रेट टू सक्सेस एंड दिस इज वॉट यू गेट
नाउ दैट यू मेंशन कान्या यू नो कान्या बॉट अ 4,000 एकर स्पेस समवेयर इन वायोमिंग
What, 4,000 acre?
Where उसको अपना बैठ के I don't want to be disturbed यहाँ पर मैं creative चीजें करूँगा नया easy design करूँगा कुछ एक गाना लिखूँगा अपना वो Sunday church service है वो करता है where he gets a bunch of these choir singers around के साथ he just bought it because उसको एक दिन ये आया epiphany कि नहीं I just need my own space that I will convert into this creative hub from which energy will flow and go out.
Speaking of all this, please watch Clarkson's farm. It's beautiful. Okay. I'm going to tell you two more of these ridiculous things that have happened. Okay. Two more ridiculous things. All right. When billionaire sheikhs from the Gulf countries travel abroad, it's a spectacle. It's often hypocrisy at its finest because they want to hold on to their religious values, but retain all the luxuries. All right. This is what the article says. When a particular high-ranking sheikh from Saudi Arabia visited the hotel where I worked as a publicity manager, he asked for two floors to be completely cordoned off from any visitors except the female hotel staff. We found out that many of the rooms were occupied by his wives.
Wives.
Often, in the middle of the night, we would hear death metal blasting from the windows of these rooms. We can only imagine what was happening during those hours.
Outstanding.
I saw this documentary on how this King Salman, the main pehle king tha before it went to MBS, when they travel, you know, what is that big ass jet that the US Army also uses?
C-17.
So they have something similar, jiske andar uske sare Rolls Royce, ye wo. क्योंकि उधर जाके वो थोड़ी उबर ले रहा है
No, so this is an advanced team. I'll talk about it. This advanced team is there for all of these people. So, different qualities of advanced teams based on your richness. But advanced teams. So
but you can't be higher than King Salman. Na? So when he is going with the entire shindig. It's not half measures. So, uske saath jo uske jo bhi 30 biwi, 25 advisor, 50 minister. सब जा रहे हैं भर के दो तीन जेट जा रहे हैं एक जेट में तेरा सिर्फ एवरीथिंग फ्रॉम योर फूड टू योर कार्स एवरीबॉडीज कार्स सिक्योरिटी खाना खाने का सामान क्योंकि उधर जाके अभी सर इधर आके आप ये खाना खाओगे नहीं मेरे को कबाब खाने का जो भी खाते सर ऑल फ्लोन डाउन पूरा होटल
कर देते हैं ठाकुर लिसन टू दिस ओके दिस इज द स्पेक्स ऑफ द मोस्ट एक्सपेंसिव private jet in the world. Okay. This is a private jet. It's an A380, Airbus A380.
This is owned by Roman, no?
No, this is owned by the Saudi Prince Al Walid bin Talal. Okay.
This is now, recent. Okay.
Yeah, so it's a opulent looking thing. It's just golden and yellow and just gold. Okay. Like full, like you need specs.
Saudi Arabia in the air.
Yeah. You need sunglasses to just be in there because of the reflection of the gold. Now, here's some of the stuff, okay? And it's such a Saudi jet. It has its own concert hall, okay? It has a Turkish bath inside. It has garage space. And here's the best part. Not just garage space for the cars. But also
for his helicopter.
Camels. Why? थोड़ी उसको भी suddenly Canada में camel पे घूमना है तो घूमेश.
Also, here's a beautiful. So it has a prayer room that rotates so that you're always facing Mecca.
Okay. So I'll talk about advanced teams. Okay. Before I was going to finish the other two things that happened, but so. Advanced teams as a concept is phenomenal. Okay. So most of these people who are extremely rich, whether you're business people or whether you are just wealthy or whatever.
Or presidents of countries.
Presidents of countries have different agendas. So security details and all go ahead.
Advanced team unke paas bhi hoti hai.
Correct. Yes. But that involves one security detail going and checking the route and all of that is happening and all. Here, I'm just talking about basic millionaires. Okay, who are sort of rich and famous. What ends up happening is whenever they're traveling, they don't lift a suitcase.
Yeah.
What ends up happening is that everything that they're going to be using over there is taken from their house or wherever it is a day and a half in advance. Mm. It goes before them. Their entire team goes and sets up wherever they're living, whether it's a hotel or whether it's a house, in exactly the same way that their house is. So their makeup, their moisturizer, their toothbrush, their toothpaste, their clothes, their this, their that, of which everything mostly has two copies. Because agar ek pe daag ho gaya to tu abhi mere ko lekin wahi chahiye to wo chahiye. So that entire thing is laid out in the cupboard so that you just go in and take it out and put your shoes in and bounce.
Seamless
transition, advanced teams. And I'm not talking about like the supremely like, you know, the best of the best of the best where security and all goes and laid out. I'm saying this is basic advanced teams. Basic.
Yaar, this is such a thing now. Like when you're packing for any kind of long trip, you're always thinking, yaar, you know, I want to take this because I may need it, but abhi it might go over on my luggage, so I'll have to pay extra for it. So fuck it. Advanced team.
But Kautuk, tu apne ispe thodi jaake bol raha hai ki set up that place where we are traveling to.
You think I wouldn't like that?
Why?
I would love it.
That's a Dilbert joke. You know, people who do this, like, what's the point of traveling if the place isn't exactly like the same place I live in?
No. The kamra I wanted to be mine. Na. Comfort is comfort.
No. I get what you're saying. I'm not saying when you're traveling for like...
You taking your favorite quilt. I get it. You taking your... Mera ye brush, mera ko shakta, I get it. to have it look exactly the same.
Thakur, what I was getting at,
that much money, I wouldn't do.
Not for leisure. When you're traveling for leisure, I get it. But if you're traveling for work, one of the things that I hate is like when we do shows and stuff, right? You have to, like, the experience of staying in new rooms all the time with the, it just is a very, like, I mean, this is, I'm not complaining about it, it's a great life, but
all promoters who want to book Kautuk for their shows,
wouldn't it be a greater life with that kind of money to have all those luxuries? Yes, 100%. Of course, okay. I get the sentiment.
Okay, I just want to finish off this last one. All right, I'm going to tell you a scenario that happened. And I want you to tell me the reason why this happened after that, okay? This is the scenario. At a restaurant in our hotel, where I work as a front office manager, we have a regular customer who consistently ranks among the top 500 richest people in the world. Even though he's usually very composed, one day something happened. So I need you to tell me the something. That night, he wanted to sleep on the table of the restaurant and asked for around 20 cooked lobsters to be laid out across his body. As if this wasn't weird enough, he asked the hotel staff to empty 3 Italian red wine bottles in an ice bucket. He dipped his shirt in that bucket and kept wiping his face for the next few hours with that $1,000 wine-soaked shirt. Of course, he had pre-booked the restaurant for the extravagantly private morning of Dash. Now, what is it that happened that led this person to do this? Remember, he's a business person.
He's mourning the loss of his dog.
Oh, no. Is it the 2008 financial crisis?
Very close. But basically, his stock price has plummeted. So, his stock price has plummeted. So, he has done this.
Ooh.
Nobody knows what the lobster...
You know what this is? No. You know what this is? Baba, this is... Fuck, mera paisa jane wala hai jaldi jitna baki hai. Ye meri aakhri khwaish puri kar leta hu. Love lobster.
Aakhri khwaish bhi tere upar lobster rag. Tu wine se apna mood ho raha
hai. Main caviar se mood hona chahta hu.
Aur lobster khaya kisne? Ki usi Rakesh lobster. Are,
kon khayega? After his body sweat has been on top of the
plate mein, acha lobster seedha uske body pe tha kaise plate mein rakhe upar rakha tha plate pe hota to main kha leta.
It's all around him.
Oh fuck. I don't want the gravy to come from somewhere else, bro.
That's arre wah, ye lobster bada tasty hai.
Ha, wo kya hai na, hum wo humme nahaya ho
red wine.
Okay. Now, I just want to tell you about a couple of things that actually more than a couple of things that rich people have done with their money. And this is of a different variety. This is of basically, you know, I think this happens to people from time to time. It's a very common thought ki, you know, life is filled with inconveniences and you're like, man, if I had money, I would just get someone, just pay someone and make them do this. Then it would be off my head.
Okay, before you go into what people have done, I'm posing the same question to you first. If you had, what is that one thing that you would do if you had a lot of money? Ki ye, usually apan sochte rehte ki mere paas paisa to main ye ek cheez karta tere liye.
I know what it would be.
Mere ko bhi maloom hai, bata tera bata.
Mine is do any kind of paperwork/admin.
Haan,
sawal. I suck at that and I wish I could just outsource it.
Agreed.
Oh, you are talking about what is...
I will send it to my house after being in my house. So, I will send it to you. I have to do it. And Nikita, in fact, we were talking about the podcast before. 24/7, 365 days from now till the end of time.
Massage.
I have to do it.
On with this plan.
और क्योंकि मेरे को बीवी को भी मसाज करना पड़ता है तो अभी मेरे को हेडेक नीचे तू कर उसको भी
मसाज नहीं सो ठाकुर तू बीवी को मसाज कर रहा है एंड व्हाइल यू आर मसाजिंग कोई तेरे को मसाज
कर रहा है हां वो बीवी अच्छा है
मसाज
क्विन नहीं करता है मसाज मेरे को लेटना है ब्रो तो मेरे को एक कांस्टेंट महसूस नॉन स्टॉप मैसेज चल रहा भी हूं ना मैसेज सेट कर रहा हूं हे गाइस माय नेम इज वरुण ठाकुर तो कोई मसाज कर रहा है पीछे से
Lower back.
So a show we take random incident, weird absurd facts that trivia and our massage stories. चल बाबा तूने तो बताया नहीं.
The massage thing sounds very good. I'm just trying to think of what.
आना ना तू बनाएगा ना किसी को अपना personal chef बाबा. Come on.
No, no. वो मेरे को मजा आता है खाना बनाने में ना. तो like I it has to be a tedious. See, this paperwork is very important.
Yes.
This massage is very important. Like I'm down for this, which is why when you said it and I was like fuck steal कर लिया. But I'm just
तू एक काम कर ले, तू एक अकाउंटेंट रख जो मसाज भी करता है. तो मसाज
आदित्य देसाई
तो भी
मसाज करता है. No, I don't mean an accountant, huh? I mean a
whatever assistant.
Yeah, just one admin person.
Form filler.
Yeah, just winning all of those, finding those nitty gritty things from your stack of papers in that drawer. It's just unbelievable.
Yeah, bro, actually, that's
I know. I know.
मेरा birth certificate का है और वो लेके आएगा, bro. Actually, मेरे पास वो है, वो मेरी माँ है, वो ऐसा करती
है. No. So I know what I want. I want someone to sort the 42 years of mine and the 68 years of my mom's paperwork that I can't possibly go through. It's just virtually impossible. Because
I'll send you my guy when I make that
money.
एक
receipt मिला है मेरे को वो दिन. मैं मम्मी का कुछ बोल रहा था. 1974 का एक stock certificate है वो.
क्या कमाया होगा ब्रो.
अरे ब्रो मेरे को वो स्टॉक सर्टिफिकेट मिल गया लेकिन मेरे को उसका ब्रोकर मतलब होल्डर कौन है वो नहीं मालूम है.
कंपनी भी बंद हो चुका है.
पड़ेगा पॉसिबली ब्रो. 74 का सर्टिफिकेट है.
ओह शिट. No, but also, if you're watching this podcast on YouTube, please also write in the comments what kind of specific tedious job would you like to outsource if you had infinite money?
And not even tedious, just any job. Maybe you just want somebody to brush your teeth for you.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. And to give you some ideas, here are a few people and they've done.
I would also...
He's already written it down as a timestamp to remove. This sneaky bastard.
If you guys want to know what that part was that Baba just cut, you're going to have to become a member on the channel. We are going to announce membership soon. So become a member and we will personally WhatsApp you all these clips that Baba doesn't let come on the final edit.
And Baba will send them to you personally. He will...
Except I have deleted all the remaining podcasts. I can start from this podcast if you want.
But we have.
Yeah.
How full do you vault have is there. The backend access?
Arre, wow, we paid a guy for it. Okay, guys. Now, here are a few things that the ultra rich have done. They've basically paid people to do these very specific tasks for them. Okay, and we'll start with Mark Wahlberg. Actor Mark Wahlberg has done the most classic thing. He has paid a person to be his morning alarm.
Wow.
वो उठता नहीं है टाइम पे.
कोई आके उसको बाबा उठो बाबा बाबा उठो. अरे यार छोटू क्यों उठा रहा
है. So there is a man whose description is कि मैं अलार्म क्लॉक हूं एंड आई एम वंडरिंग वेदर हिज फेस इज अ स्नूज बटन. झापड़ मार 5 मिनट और
मार्क वॉलबर्ग को झापड़ मारे तेरी कितनी बढ़ रही होगी कि अगर मार्क का सपना देख रहा है तूने उसको बजा दिया तो वो तेरे को कितना मारेगा. कितना मारेगा तेरे को मार्क वॉलबर्ग ब्रो.
नाउ अपना किंग चार्ल्स फॉर्मरली प्रिंस चार्ल्स. ओके. This is unbelievable, all right? But according to reports, apparently King Charles has never undressed himself in his life. He has a professional undresser.
No wonder Diana was fried with him. You want to have sex? 1 second, darling. Albert. any second now. Charles, I'm just crowned the most beautiful woman in the world. I'm in your bed. The fuck is going on? Yes, sire.
And then she's like, okay, Albert, can you also please leave?
Ma'am, would you like some assistance?
Albert. So here's another factoid, which is equally unbelievably weird, is that King Charles also. Now, tell me something. You know, everyone likes to wear iron clothes. But where do you stop with the ironing? What part of your clothing?
When a big chunk of it is stuck to the back of the iron, and then you pick it up and now you have a gaping hole.
That's
your
not what I meant. Like, what item of clothing would you stop?
I don't iron anything. To ironing? Sure. I'm assuming a handkerchief.
Chaddi ko maine ek bar istri kiya.
Good, good. You're still, it's within the realm of humanity.
Handkerchief.
What the fuck is Charles doing?
King Charles is ironing his shoelaces.
ये अच्छा हुआ ये पहले नहीं बना मोनार्की खत्म हो जाती है बेंचो अगर
पहले इसके लिए तो मम्मी जी बोल रही है भाई मैं इसको कैसे बनाऊं यार ये तो अपना शूले कर रहे
चार्ल्स आर यू रेडी
जस्ट हे मम्मी दो मिनट नहीं पहले वो नहीं एल्बर्ट कपड़ा पहना रहा है फिर एल्बर्ट इस्त्री कर रहा है तो थोड़ा प्रॉब्लम है ना
अच्छा ये कपड़े खुद नहीं पहनता लेकिन अपना शू लेसेस खुद इस्त्री करता है
नहीं नहीं एल्बू कर रहा है एल्बू
अबे एल्बर्ट उसका प्रोफेशनल अंड्रेसर है
अरे उसका एक्चुअल नाम एल्बर्ट नहीं है वी मेड इट अप ऑन द पॉड
मतलब एल्बर्ट एनी कोइंसिडेंस टू एनी पर्सन लिविंग और डेड
अपने जूते क्यों आयरन कर रहा है भाई
क्यों आयरन कर रहा है जूते के लेसेस कर रहा है ना जूते थोड़ी आयरन कर रहा है उसने नया लेदर जूता पहना ऐसे थोड़ा उस सामने ऐसा क्रीज आ गया तो मैं looks like the leather got stuck on the back of the iron
who has looked at his laces and told him ki yaar bahut क्रीज आ गया यार
क्या यार चार्ल्स थोड़ा तो प्रोफेशनल बन मतलब ये ऐसा
कैसे बनेगा तू किंग
ब्रो आई थिंक समवन प्रैंक्ड हिम व्हेन ही वाज वेरी यंग I think someone told him.
Oh, he has a lot of unresolved issues.
Yeah. Oh, handobi.
I think that's what being next in line for 70 years can do to a person. कि चुतिया नहीं जा रही है मेरी मम्मी. मैं कभी नहीं बनूंगा king. तो हो जाए थोड़ा shoelaces को इस्त्री.
शायद ये. You're saying he did it to fill time.
Yes. अभी क्या करूँ? मैंने सबको तो night out दे दिया. हाँ इधर आ तो night out ले भाई. मैं अपने सब टोर वोर करके आया अभी मेरे पास बहुत टाइम है तो हो
जाए ओह शिट क्लासिक ओके नाउ हियर्स अ गाय हु आई अगेन आई फील लाइक दिस इज सच अ परफेक्ट थिंग टू आउटसोर्स ओके दिस मैन्स नेम इज रॉबर्ट सैमुअल राइट एंड हिज जॉब इज दैट ही इज अ प्रोफेशनल क्यूअर वो क्यू में जाके खड़ा होता है
100% दिस इज नो सो दिस प्रॉब्लम इज मोर प्रेवलेंट इन आउटसाइड इंडिया में स्ट्रेट लाइन मतलब सेमी सर्कल ठीक है अरे मैं यहाँ रुमाल लग के जा रहा हूँ किसी को आने मत देना
रुमाल इज आर रॉबर्ट सैमुअल
रुमाल इज आर ठीक है मैंने रुमाल रखा था सो लोग अब ऐसे रुमाल के सामने तो मैंने देखा ही होते हुए हम लोग अंधेरी स्टेशन पे टिकट लेने खरीदे ट्रेन के हम लोग खड़े और लोग रुके तो पीछे वाले बोले भाई आगे जाओ उधर नहीं इधर कोई और है तो बोलते कौन है तब उन्होंने ऐसा देखा तो रुमाल पड़ा है वो जस्ट अभी आ रहे हैं मतलब तू क्यों इतना फॉलो कर रहे चुके 9:30 बजे तो अंधेरी स्टेशन पे दिस इज निकल डोन मार दे उसको आगे टिकट खरीद बट सॉरी द रीजन आई वाज सेइंग दिस इज बिकॉज़ यू नोटिस एवरी टाइम यू गो आउट ऑफ इंडिया राइट इन यूरोप अमेरिका वेरेवर ब्रो गोरे लोग को लाइन में खड़ा रहना बहुत पसंद है
बहुत ज्यादा
और उन लोग खड़े थे लंबा लंबा 1 किलोमीटर लंबी लाइन मैं खड़ा था हम लोग जब साइनफेल्ड को देखने गए लिटरली फ्रॉम द स्टार्ट ऑफ द क्लब टू फॉर लाइक 1 किलोमीटर इतना लंबा लाइन ऐसे था और सब पब्लिक खड़े एकदम
दैट्स बाय द वे यू नो समथिंग सो द वन ऑफ द रूमर्स फॉर वेयर द वर्ड ब्लॉकबस्टर कम्स फ्रॉम इज बेसिकली दिस कि back in the day when a movie did so well people used to make a line at the ticket window that used to go around a whole block So it was a blockbuster, and that's how much the line used
and
to.
Also, the other urban legend is that German bombs that would bust an entire block.
There you go. So there's multiple.
Oh, that's quite.
But it's a very different.
Let's name this 1 billion earning movie about something. What do we call it? How about we correlate it to the Nazis dropping bombs? Great idea, Albert. Let's do it.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Would you like me to take off your clothes? Sorry?
Okay. Now, let me tell you about Larry Ellison, okay, the man behind, the guy who created Oracle. Okay, now he's worth about some 50 billion or thereabouts. Okay, and this guy is a very big fan of basketball. But because he's also so damn rich, he plays basketball on his yacht. But when you play basketball on a yacht, sometimes
the ball goes into the ocean.
The ball goes into the ocean. Now, when you are Larry Ellison and you have $50 billion.
You have a scuba diver who goes and recovers the basketball.
You have a basketball.
Simultaneously on all sides.
You have a basketball retriever. A man who is on a speedboat going, chasing your yacht. And anytime the ball comes out, he just shouts, "Uncle, ball, ball." And then you jump in.
Guys, anybody who's been in a building in India while playing cricket already has this person called Chota Bhai. Abhi ja ball leke aa tu. Maine nahi dala, tu leke aa. They have no option
third man.
But to go and get the ball. Hamesha tu chote bachcho ko bhejega. Jo ek kaccha limbu hai, tera chota bhai hai, tu ja leke aa.
Aur wicket keeper.
नहीं लेकिन विकेट कीपर अगर बड़ा हुआ तो वो भी नहीं जाएगा
वो भी नहीं जाएगा सबसे छोटा जो भी है वो जाएगा
पूजा लेके आप बोल
दैट्स द टैक्स यू पे फॉर प्लेइंग
बच्चे लोगों को भागने मजा आता ना अरे मुझे बड़े लोगों के साथ खेलने मिल रहा है तो ठीक है
आई टू रीथिंक अ लॉट ऑफ माय चाइल्डहुड आई थिंक
यस यस बाबा
और के बॉल लेके आता था
दो-तीन बार तो किया है
But it's a rite of passage. I mean, you do it as a kid, so you can instruct other kids when you're older.
अभी सबको नस्ते खालेगा बाबा.
Okay. Last one. Okay. This is so beautiful and so relatable. And if I had money, this would also be something I would 100% do. So this is a story of Howard Hughes. Okay. Famous aviator and general entrepreneur. Okay. And eccentric rich person. Right. Now, here's what happens to Howard Hughes. Howard Hughes at one point in his life moved to Las Vegas and there he's living in a penthouse and very relatable situation where he switches on the television and as he's surfing through channels, there's nothing to watch. How many times have we felt this particular experience, right? Ki are kuch hai hi nahi dekhne ke liye. But when you're Howard Hughes and you're that rich and that eccentric, here's what you do. You go out and you buy a television station. So he goes out and buys a television station and basically, here's what they have to do. Okay. They have to take detailed notes from Howard Hughes as to what to play. They have to send him. Yeah, what he likes to watch, right? They have to send him detailed synopsis of what they're going to program. And if he doesn't like something, they have to change it. And if he really likes something, they have to keep playing it. Okay. So people in Las Vegas used to find out when Howard Hughes was in town. Because they would switch to that channel and invariably there would be a movie called Ice Station Zebra that would be playing. And every time that movie was playing, that was his favorite movie. And sometimes that movie would play again and again, continuously on the same day, multiple times. That's when people would know, okay, achha, Howard News aaya aaj. Last week.
But if you're Howard News at that point in time, you can say, ye kaam karo, ye jitne actor hai Ice Station Zebra, mein sabko bulao. मेरे सामने करे ही है अभी तेरे पास इतना पैसा है तो कराएगा ना कि तू बैठ मेरे सामने कर
ब्रो he made Netflix happen way before Netflix like you know I want my programming pause rewind replay
this is like अम्बानी के शादी पे संगीत पे आके साला क्रिस मार्टिन गा रहा है
yeah
कौन से गा रही है मतलब literally संगीत पे ब्रो जो अपने इधर एक डीजे वही 16 गाने ऑन लूप बजा रहा है इधर आके क्रिस मार्टिन तेरे लिए
वो भी हिंदी में जो वो सीखा है क्योंकि उसको
जाने जा तो नो जवाब क्रिस की
अरिजीत सिंह कोल्डप्ले गा रहा है.
तो बॉयज ऑब्वियसली ये टॉपिक पे अपन शायद 12
पार्ट 4 करेंगे,
ठीक है, क्योंकि द शिट दैट रिच पीपल डू इज नेवर एंडिंग. बट क्विकली टू रैप ऑफ, सिंस वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट क्रेजी स्टफ पीपल हैव डन, सेलिब्रिटीज हैव डन विद देयर मनी, राइट? सो रिमेंबर आई टोल्ड यू अबाउट 2 मिलियन एज अ रॉन्ग फिगर अर्लियर. आई विल टेल यू व्हाट दैट 2 मिलियन फॉर वाज फॉर नाउ. सो सेलिन डियोन, ओके, सेलिन डियोन स्पेंट $2 million ऑन अ ह्यूमिडिफायर, ठीक है, बिकॉज जब भी वो गाती है अपने वोकल कॉर्ड्स के लिए, इट्स इंपॉर्टेंट, ह्यूमिडिटी इज इंपॉर्टेंट. आई डोंट नो द साइंस बिहाइंड इट, बट ह्यूमिडिटी चाहिए उसके लिए. सो फॉर हर वोकल कॉर्ड शी गॉट अ $2 million ह्यूमिडिफायर, $200 का मिलता है जो सेम काम करता है, ठीक है, लेकिन उसने $2 million का ह्यूमिडिफायर.
डिड शी गेट इट सो दैट हर वॉइस विल गो ऑन?
वाओ वाओ. अभी बाबा तूने इतना अच्छा जोक बनाया तो मुझे लगता है यही खत्म कर देना
चाहिए. या 100% ऑन दैट नोट,
ऑन
ऑन दैट नोट
माय बाबा. वाओ ब्रो, सी लाइक दिस सॉर्ट ऑफ एन एंडिंग इज लाइक म्यूजिक टू माय इयर्स.
करेक्ट,
इट्स पिच परफेक्ट. चलो
क्या बात है है कुछ और
नहीं? इस जोक को कंप्लीट करने के लिए बोनो का हैट लाना पड़ेगा.
Now, sir, I only take it off. Oh, sorry. Can you call Chris?
I think it's anyway. Time.
Before delirium sets in, because it is 12:45 on a Tuesday night, or hum log thoda khatam ho rahe. So that's it from this episode of the Internet Set. So we were talking about the crazy things which people do. If you've heard of any stories that we probably missed out on, let us know in the comments. It'll be fun to hear.
And, actually, wait, just one thing. Okay. When you're putting these things in the comments, let's do one thing. It'll be fun.
Varun's sound was a little off. It was causing me a lot of inconvenience.
Is this better? Okay, on that note.
Abhi kam karo na volume. On that note, that's it for this episode of the Internet Set. So, we were talking about crazy things that rich people do. If you know any other crazy things they do, let us know in the comments. Please make sure you like, share, subscribe, share it with your friends, share it with your family. Please help us get out there,
spread the word. Yeah,
I know you guys already do it, but we are greedy, so we'll keep asking for it. And please make sure you check out links for all the tickets for all our shows. They're all there in the pinned comment. Go buy tickets for the shows. And that's it. We'll see you again next week. Until then, good night, bye bye, take care, salamish.
One second, I have to plug one thing. Baba and I are going to be in Toronto on the 19th of March. One second, but I just want to tell them 19th of March, we've sold out one show, we've added another. This is the last show we'll be doing. So if you're in Canada, Toronto, please get those tickets. And Secondhand Stories is right now in production. I'm doing live stories. So if you enjoy long form storytelling, then become a member of the channel and I'll see you on those live sessions.
Also, guys, please fucking get with it. It's Toronto. It's not Toronto.
जब जाएंगे फिर वापस आएंगे.
टू द शो प्लीज लेट देम नो इन द कमेंट्स दैट इट्स टोरंटो एंड इट्स नॉट टोरंटो. यू कैन आल्सो गो टू जस्टिन ट्रूडोस इंस्टाग्राम अकाउंट एंड आस्क हिम वेदर इज टोरंटो और इज इट टोरंटो.
इट्स टोरंटो,
इट्स टोरंटो, टोरंटो. एनीवे चल, इसके पहले अपन अभी यही चलते रहेगा, 1.5 घंटा यही चल जाएगा. सो थैंक यू गाइस फॉर वॉचिंग, लिसनिंग, शेयरिंग, सब्सक्राइबिंग. बाय, फाइनल टाइम नाउ, बाय.
But for real, like
तेरे को बास आ रहा है कि क्या ऐसी शक्ल क्यों बना है?
वेडनेसडे हो गया है गाइस.
दिस बाबा व्हाट ही जस्ट डिड राइट नाउ जस्ट रिमाइंड मी ऑफ जो कॉमिक कैरेक्टर्स होते हैं ना मूवी में, द फर्स्ट टाइम यू सी देम देयर इज ऑलवेज दैट क्लोजर शॉट ऑन देयर फेस. पर कुछ ऐसा हम लोग करते बिफोर दे से अ वर्ड टू वो किया है फिलहाल.
Before we started this podcast on Tuesday, it is Wednesday.
Oh, wow.
So,
one whole day.